I was watching Arnold's show, FUBAR.
Did you go? I couldn't get past the first episode.
Dude, I couldn't either, but then I had to. Like, I was so annoyed with it. It's so badly done that after the first episode, I'm like, I need more of awfulness. I want to see how bad this is going to get. And it gets worse and worse and worse.
You came along. What was the plan?
Kill all of you.
Kill all of you.
And now, with all our guns out?
I'll manage.
You're the fastest 65-year white guy on the planet.
I guess I'm done.
65? He's like 70-something.
You are officially retired.
How are you going to spend your golden years, huh?
I'm with my family.
I missed you.
Now since I'm retired, I'm going to meet my wife back. What's going to stop us?
15-year-old divorce papers?
She doesn't love you anymore. Luke, can I talk to you for a minute? We're going to lose an operative. Codename's Panda.
I'm retired.
I'm retired.
Extract Panda.
I'm retarded.
Zip on now.
What? That's his daughter.
Holy shit.
My daughter's in the CIA.
What the f***?
My daughter's in the CIA.
Dollar in the swear jar.
I know where the WMD's toward, so follow me or get out of my way.
She clearly has daddy issues.
Right, the big guy.
He treats
the
me
black
like
dude.
A child.
Alcohol, cigarettes, and the garish lipstick.
That's not lipstick. Oh my God.
It's vibrating, my God.
I am not doing this vibrator.
Emma.
I'm okay, just take him out.
Look at that. I broke a hip.
What?
I've learned a ton from working with my dad.
Oh,
how
God.
He leads the team, how he
it's
keeps his cool,
so bad.
How to slit a man's throat vertically so he bleeds out faster.
Mm-hmm. They got more issues than Sports Illustrated.
That's funny. Fuck it.
Everyone in the van, now.
Now, get to the chopper.
That was on me.
This is totally.
FUBAR. Oh, dude.
You should end the marriage before you.
Do you think I'm a virgin?
Well, let me think what I want to think.
Oh my God, I'm 28.
I was so funny. Yeah, okay. This is supposed to kind of be like a True Lies thing, which I think is one of Arnold's best movies. That's a great fucking movie. Obviously, he's a spy in True Lies, and his wife doesn't know. His family, you know, doesn't know. They think he's some boring guy that does. And in this, his family didn't know. His daughter especially didn't know. And they thought he just sold gym equipment. So it's the same kind of premise. But here's the twist. The daughter is also in the CIA, and he doesn't know. God. The writing is horrific. It is everything you'd expect in 2023. It's got all the wokeness, all the PC thing. The person in charge, the head muckety-muck of the CIA, is a black woman that could play a judge in any TV show. Like, and she's the authority and straight ahead, straightforward kind of a authority figure. And then you got the brilliant black dude who dresses like casual and talks a little ghetto. And then he got the fat bull dyke woman who's always making like lesbian jokes, and she's obviously a lesbian. And then you got the handsome white dude who's constantly being looked at as a white dude, you know? And then Arnold is thrown into the whole thing to be the same character he was. And the action is silly. The characters are silly, and it doesn't have that same charm and adventurous action thing that True Lies had.
Is Tom Arnold playing the Tom Arnold character?
No, Tom Arnold is in it, but Tom Arnold plays like a torture guy. He tortures Ooh. People, and he's kind of crazy. Like, he loves it. He loves torturing people. So he comes in, and, you know, he starts torturing some guy with a corkscrew in his leg and his groin, I think, and he really enjoys what he does. So the fact that he's in it and everything, it's like this weird other dimension of True Lies. So I don't know. Arnold, look, God bless him, but he's just too old. He's just too old to do shit like this. It's silly when you see him fighting on a moving vehicle and being flung off. And, you know, he's fine. And he's beating up people half his age. And, you know, it just doesn't. Him and Stallone. Like, Stallone is. That last Rocky, that last Rambo they did. Like, John Rambo wouldn't have gotten plastic surgery. And there's no way they could make Sylvester Stallone look like he didn't have plastic surgery. So seeing him like, I fought in Vietnam, and he's like, I'm just an everyman. I went to war. He used to die for his blood. He used to die. And he's like, his fucking face is insane. It just doesn't work anymore. I guess he could do that show. What was that one he's been doing? Tulsa? Tulsa, the mob show? Is that even on? What was it? A limited series? A movie? Who knows? From people that watched The Sopranos. I love how they try to, like, fit something in there. Yes. Filmed through one of the lenses that was similar to a lens that was used to film The Sopranos. Ooh, gotta see that. So, yeah, and like that I could see, because, you know, vanity. He might have had corrective plastic surgery or some shit. And they dressed him in like a Gotti kind of suit, like a John Gotti kind of suit. You know, that worked, kind of. But it's so weird seeing some of these celebrities that are into their 70s now that were known to be action heroes and action stars, because you want to, you know, you want to root for him. I'd love to see Arnold in one of those roles. When Arnold in True Lies, when he does that, you know, the head turn and his eyebrow goes up like he's fucking ready to kill someone, he looked like he was gonna kill someone. It was awesome. Now it just, he goes like, oh no, what's that, Parkinson's? What do you got there? A little shaky. Shouldn't be smoking that cigar at your age. So it's, you know, it's a little disheartening. I don't know. But that is an awful show. I watched like 4 episodes. Dude, you were out after one, right?
It's like still in my continue watching, and I just can't fucking.
Bah. Yeah, I just, I watched 4 and then I fell asleep. The next day, I had no ambition to continue watching, and I won't. I will not watch another episode of that show, but I did watch 4, and it's just so, it's kind of dull. It's so, it's just such a shitty little formula. Every episode is like a new thing they have to do, like a new mission that entails this bad guy, but sometimes to get to the bad guy, they got to do another mission first to get information on where the bad guy is. So there's these peripheral episodes and then the main story, which is the main bad guy. Arnold killed his father when they was younger and raised him and took care of him. But now he knows that Arnold killed his father. Now he wants to kill Arnold. And Arnold,